In terms of a formal definition, a desert is a region typically characterized by an extreme lack of rainfall. One of the prime causes behind an area receiving little rainfall is being on the wrong side of the mountain. For example, consider a weather system blowing in from the west and bumping into a north-south mountain range. The damp, warm air that rolled up against the base of the mountain will now begin to rise and form clouds. However, as the air rises, it begins to cool, causing it to release its moisture in the form of precipitation. By the time the air moves over the top of the mountain range, it is largely devoid of moisture, aside from a few clouds that don't produce much precipitation. The east side of the mountain is called a rain shadow, where the air will descend and warm up, but will not have any moisture. This often results in hot, dry winds that can exacerbate the formation of a desert over thousands or millions of years. Over the course of millions of years, weather patterns and topographical factors result in a land that is largely bereft of any vegetative cover, as there is often too little water to support life, and the ever-changing landscape makes it difficult for root systems to take hold. These deserts are also susceptible to temperature shifts, since they gain and lose heat very easily, resulting in drastic temperature swings, yet another obstacle to life thriving. Now, where does the sand come from in the first place? The drastic shifts in temperature between day and night mentioned earlier can put stress on the rocks of a region, which may split and crack. Combine this with the dry, gusting winds that readily cause erosion, and you get a great deal of sand being formed over the course of millennia. The sand will basically sort itself by size, with the larger and heavier pieces of broken down sand at the bottom, and the fine, silt-like sand on the surface, where it can be whipped around and blown into dunes, or further aid the weathering process of wind erosion. Sand behaves as an abrasive substance, and with the wind stripping the earth down to its rocky bones, unusual rock formations and outcroppings may be molded by the power of gusting sand alone. Dune seas are ever-shifting landscapes grown and molded by the wind into various recognizable formations, but they may rise and fall in a matter of years. Roughly 80% of deserts aren't covered with sand, but actually show the bare earth below, the bedrock and cracking clay of a dried-out ecosystem. Without any soil to cover it, nor vegetation to hold that soil in place, the desert stone is completely uncovered and exposed to the elements. A desert is not necessarily flat, so hills and rock formations are either weathered down to the flat earth below or shaped into outcroppings through erosion. Rolling plains of dunes may hint at rolling hills that once existed beneath them. There is a very good chance that the exposed areas of a desert are the same as those covered by sand, provided they are geographically close. Furthermore, as deserts grow, it isn't that the sand is spreading out, but rather the ecosystems on the edges of the desert are giving way as the soil blows away. Vegetation decreases, and erosive processes begin.